In the last video, we talked about some of the Azure SQL Managed Instance deployment options, as well as the service tiers. In this video, we're going to dive into the same thing for Azure SQL Database.
Now, before, when we talked about managed instance, your first choice was to choose a SQL instance or an instance pool. For database, you have a similar choice. You're going to pick a single database with several different options, which we'll talk about, or something called an elastic pool. An elastic pool is something we developed several years ago, especially for hosters that have a scenario where they have a large number of databases they want to provide for their customers, but want to share resources and cost amongst those databases. So again, you first pick a single database or an elastic pool, and then you need to make another choice. And before, with managed instance, you picked a vCore purchasing model. Well, for database, you actually have two choices for your purchasing model. You have something called a database transaction unit model, which is one of our earlier models we first released with what was called SQL Azure back then, where you pick things based on what's called a database transaction unit measurement and different tiers within that. And the vCore model is actually what we recommend. So you picked your database or a pool. Now you pick your purchasing option. And if you choose the vCore model, then like managed instance, you're going to have service tier choices.
For Azure SQL Database, there are three service tiers available. Two of them we're familiar with are the same from managed instance. That's the general purpose and the business critical tier. And the same sort of recommendation and guidance is going to go along here. Most of our customers are going to be just fine on general purpose, whereas some customers might want some of the extra benefits that come with business critical. These are the exact same comparisons as with SQL Managed Instance. With business critical, you're going to have everything on local SSD. You're going to get better I/O per second. You're going to spend a little bit more in comparison to general purpose, and we're going to support you for your in-memory OLTP workloads. Now, one thing that's different from general purpose in Azure SQL Database versus SQL Managed Instance is this idea of serverless compute. So in all the other tiers, you only choose between provisioned compute. There's no choice, actually. With general purpose, you can choose between provisioned and serverless compute. And serverless is really going to be good for those scenarios where you have intermittent or unpredictable workloads. Because while you're running, we can scale you on a per second basis to the max CPU or memory that you need at that time. And we can use some clever caching to bring you back down. But when you enter a period of inactivity, for example, maybe it's a business application and no one really uses it after hours, we'll actually shut down SQL Server and separate the compute from the storage. And during that time, you're only going to pay for the storage and not the compute. So this can be great cost savings for things like business applications or applications that have weird cycles or even like your dev test workloads. So those are the two tiers that have been around for a while. And there's also a third tier called Hyperscale.
You know, Hyperscale is an amazing technology. Our customers in the last few years had told us that the sizes of their databases are pretty large when it comes to SQL enterprise applications. So the size limits today for Azure Database for general purpose of business critical, which is like 4 and 8 terabytes, just doesn't quite frankly meet the needs of some of our large scale customers. So we created a technology called Hyperscale. It was called Project Socrates. And this is going to use a different architecture behind the scenes, but it's going to still feel like an Azure SQL Database. Your interactions with it are the same, but there's many great advantages to it. So it's going to give you highly scalable storage and even more capabilities for read, replica, and scale requirements. So what we're going to do is we're going to use a combination of local and remote storage. Your databases are going to be remote storage, but we're going to use something called caches. It's going to be a series of local storage across several different nodes to cache things like database pages or transaction log data. Now, IOPS are going to be similar to what you have with something like business critical, where you're going to get a lot more IOPS than you say from general purpose. But here's the key, you're going to get unlimited storage. Today, we support even up to 100 terabyte databases in Hyperscale. We expect that to even go further. Scaling operations are constant. As you're changing your scaling needs for Hyperscale, the time it takes to scale from a couple of CPUs to 80 CPUs is a kind of a constant time. And one of the best benefits is your ability to get more replicas. So by default, you don't even have to have any replicas. As you choose replicas, you get higher availability, but you can even get up to 4 read replicas in a read scale fashion from Hyperscale. So you see, Hyperscale is kind of that third option general purpose and business critical, that is really meant for that scaling need for our Azure SQL database customers. Now, one possible last choice you may have to make is hardware choice. So if we try to abstract you from that, but you may have some choices you need to make to take advantage of modern hardware platforms in Azure.
Yeah, and really today, at the time of this recording at least, the main hardware choice for you is going to be this Gen 5 hardware. But what you'll see over time is that we're always going to be adopting the latest and greatest hardware that can give you additional capabilities. On the right, you'll see some options that are currently available in preview. And you can expect that over time, these are going to change. You might see Gen 7, Gen 8, or even a different naming system. So just know that we're going to keep evolving this hardware to give you the latest and greatest capabilities as far as getting you more storage or getting you more vCores. So now you've seen some of the different options that are available for Azure SQL Database, whether it's the DTU or the vCore model, or the service tier, or the hardware choices. A lot of options, but really we're just trying to make it so you can get exactly what you need when you need it. Stay tuned for the next video.